Well, now that they're in the top 10, the Idol finalists are on the way to becoming celebrities themselves. And they shared with me their secret celebrity crushes. Since they live in Hollywood, anything is possible. This heartstopper sang about the power of love, but when asked what celeb makes him go gaga, his answer took me way back.
Lucille Ball.
Casey claims he grew up with no TV and isn't familiar with who's hot in Hollywood. We do have our top Idol 5. The contestants spend so much time choosing that perfect song, but there's always a message in the music, one that's been hidden until now. Let me
love you. Have you noticed? Casey James sure does sing a lot about love. Seems he wears his heart on his guitar strings.
All the ladies out there want to know, is Casey James a single man?
Yes, he is.
And is he looking for love?
I always am, yes, but I'm busy. It's crazy. It's hard. You know, it's hard to spend time with anyone.
I'm Stacy from Atlanta. Yeah, are they yelling Stacy or Casey?
They're yelling for you.
I'm just kidding. So, wow, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So many of us wanted to see you up there tonight. So you could let your hair down again.
You know what? You get to see it tomorrow night.
Well, that's true. Can you talk about that at all?
I can't talk about what's going to happen, but I can tell you that it's going to be a great show, and I'm probably going to have my hair down.
You are? Really?
Yeah. The big late-breaking news story.
Oh, that's huge. Well, I held up a T-shirt this morning that said, Cougars for Casey. Does that scare you now to think these women are after you like this?
Of course not. It's an honor. It's an honor that somebody wants, you know, is attracted to me, and I think it's nice. I think it's very nice.
Well, Kara started it all.
Thank you. Yeah.
So what do you think about the two finals now? What do you...
You know, the whole show was amazing, and it's going to be interesting to see what happens tomorrow, I can tell you that.
Do you have a favorite?
Of course not.
No, not even. Okay, what about Simon leaving? Give me your take on that.
Sad to see him go.
Yeah.
Sad to see him go.
He's irreplaceable.
I think so, you know. I think he is irreplaceable, but you never know. It might be really cool. It might be really cool. Whatever happens next could be really interesting.
Okay, thank you, Casey.
American Idol Madness took over Broadway today. For many of the top 10, this was their very first time to New York City. The Idols took a big bite out of the Big Apple, or make that the Big M&M. Casey James is also a first-timer to the Big Apple, and this blonde bachelor is looking for a tour guide.
I want to do it all. I want to see the Empire State Building. I want to see the Statue of Liberty. I want to do all the touristy dumb things that people love to do, and I want to eat the pizza.
This is my home. I do live in Astoria, Queens, so...
Is this your farewell song?
Yeah, that was my cousin's daughter.
People ask me if I pick up a random
child.
I know, what's that?
All right, Casey, who is this child that you're holding in your arms?
That's my cousin's daughter.
Oh, she is sweet.
That's Casey James saying goodbye to everybody on American Idol. He's saying hello to us on Good Day New York. Welcome to New York, Casey James.
Hey, thanks. It's great to be here.
How do you feel?
Yeah.
I feel good. I'm just glad to be here. It was amazing to get as far as I did in the show, and I mean, as a result, I'm sitting here with you guys this morning.
Well, we're happy that you're here. So since American Idol ended, what has happened in your life since you've gotten here?
Oh, so much. You know, I mean, like all the reasons that I tried out for the show in the first place are...
Like?
You know, getting a record out there, that was the biggest one, you know.
So that's going to happen?
Yeah, I'm pretty positive that's going to happen.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Casey, Cara Diaguardi. In the early stages of the show, was like obsessed with you, bizarrely obsessed, strangely obsessed. Was it ever uncomfortable? I mean, basically, she was openly kind of infatuated with you.
I've been doing music for like 11 years, and so I've played a lot of bars and a lot of restaurants.
You've been there before.
Yeah, you just deal with, you know, if something comes up and you just deal with it, you know. And
let's show the folks what you had to deal with. Roll it.
Casey, I don't recognize you with your shirt on, first off.
Last time
we saw each other. Wow, you know, it was hard for me to kind of listen to that because I was, you know, I'm married. Honey, I love you.
Okay, so did that make you feel uncomfortable?
No.
Did it make you feel aroused?
What are you asking?
It's a fair question.
And moving forward.
All right. Unfair question. I apologize. Casey, all right, I got to ask you one more cosmetic thing. We were talking about this before. I noticed a correlation. When your hair was down or out, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just, you'd be a bigger hit than when the hair was back. And you're telling me 50 million people watch this show and no one ever made that correlation.
No, and I tell you what, that is complete coincidence if it really was. I'll have to watch the show back and see what happened.
All right, let's talk about your last performance. You actually sang with Bret Michaels.
Yes.
What was that like?
Oh, it was so amazing. I mean, number one, you know, I've been a fan of the guy for a long time. And not only, I mean, I went through a life or death experience myself. And
what happened to you?
I was in a motorcycle accident.
Oh.
So, you know, when I met Bret, I mean, he's immediately, you get a sense of who he is immediately, and he's the nicest guy ever.
Were you concerned because, you know, he wasn't feeling so well?
Well, yeah, I knew that he had been, you know, ill and everything, and when I met him, I was kind of concerned, but, I mean, 5 minutes of meeting him, I'm like, wow, this guy's...
Was he okay in person?
Yeah, he's totally, totally... I mean, he's still struggling, you know, but, I mean... You can tell that the music does it for him. I mean, he came out there and killed it.
When he came out, we thought we were seeing things. You know what I mean? We weren't expecting it.
Yeah.
It was so amazing. Just to be a part of that, you know, for him to go through what he went through and then to come back and for me to be on stage and be a part of that first performance, I mean, what an honor.
Casey, what were you doing a year ago before all this started? A year ago this
Playing
week?
Music for very, very small amounts of money.
Like what?
Were you able to pay your bills?
Barely, yeah. Sometimes no, but, you know. I mean, I've got good friends, so.
Well, Casey James, it's great to meet you. Congratulations.
Thank you so
much. Did you get a recording contract yet?
Not 100% yet, but it's looking really good.
It's looking good.
Yeah.
But a song is going to be released.
Yeah.
Do you want to say what song? What?
Well, no, I mean, nothing yet, but as soon as I know, and if it goes through, then I'll have a record out pretty quick.
Excellent.
All right, Casey James, again, really cool to meet you in person. We watched a lot, you know what I mean? So when you guys come in and we can sit down with you, it's fun for us, big time.
That's cool. It's good, yeah. Good to meet you all.
Nice to meet you, too. Have fun in New York City.
Thanks. I'm having a blast.
Oh, good. All right, and...
Lead to Wise is coming up.
Right, but meanwhile, Casey's going to be on the American Idol tour this summer as well. Do you know when that starts, by chance?
July 1st.
July 1st, and we'll find out when it's coming to our area. I'm sure we'll have all the information on our website. Meanwhile, Lee DeWise coming up about 9:30 this morning.
Stay connected with MyFoxNY.com mobile. Download the iPhone app or text Fox 5 to 46988 for other devices. Local news, weather, and traffic on the go with MyFoxNY.com mobile.